There are a lot of myths about vaccinations. Let's talk about this one.
I've heard vaccines have toxins that will make me sick.
This is a big myth. You may have heard or read that mercury in vaccines causes autism. This is simply not correct. There has been a mercury-containing preservative used in vaccines since the early 1930s called thimerosal. But thimerosal has not been used to preserve routine pediatric vaccines since early 2002. There have been many studies looking for a link between thimerosal and autism, and every one of them failed to find a connection. Even the most passionate vaccine opponents can't defend the myth that mercury in vaccine causes autism because there is just no evidence to support that myth. The mercury contained in thimerosal is not biologically active. In fact, it's less dangerous to get a vaccine preserved with thimerosal than it is to eat a can of tuna one day a week for a year. Let me explain. There are different types of mercury. Methylmercury is the kind found in tuna fish. It can have disastrous effects on the brain if it accumulates in the human body. Methylmercury is not the same kind of mercury found in thimerosal. That compound is called ethylmercury, and that's the ingredient that's been used to protect vaccines from getting contaminated. There's a big difference between methylmercury and ethylmercury. Some have compared it to the difference between a shot of alcohol and a shot of antifreeze. One can make you blind drunk, the other can make you blind. The thimerosal myth should not be a barrier to getting a vaccine. Since the thimerosal myth doesn't work anymore, people who argue that vaccines cause more harm than good have now begun to spread the myth that vaccines contain other toxins that will make you sick, like aluminum and formaldehyde. Okay, let's take a look at those. Aluminum is the third most abundant element on our planet. It's found naturally in food, water, formula, and breast milk. It is used in low levels in vaccines. Aluminum helps the body build stronger immunity against the germs in the vaccines. You have the greater exposure to aluminum in your underarm deodorant than in the tiny doses in any vaccines. Babies who are breastfed exclusively will consume more than twice as much aluminum in the first 6 months of life drinking breast milk than they will from all the childhood vaccines normally recommended by your physician. Let's talk about formaldehyde. Yes, it's sometimes used in the manufacturing process, but the fact is formaldehyde is a natural byproduct of our metabolism. It is already produced at higher levels within our bodies than any vaccine could ever add. According to the United States Department of Health and Human Services, formaldehyde is naturally produced in very small amounts in our body as a part of our normal, everyday metabolism and causes us no harm. Once you have the facts, it's easy to see through the myth to the truth. Talk to your doctor and get the facts about vaccines and do your part to protect New Jersey. Thank you.